Welcome to this video. Now we're going to solve a coding interview question, word break. You're given a non-empty string S and a dictionary, word dict, containing a list of non-empty words. Determine if S can be segmented into a space-separated sequence of one or more dictionary words. This is the problem statement. For example, if you are given S equals to LeetCode and word dict equals to this list of words, we have Leet and Code word in this word dictionary. Now we can generate this string from this word dictionary. We have here the word Leet and we have the word code. So in this case, we have to return true. If we are given this string apple, pen, apple, and word dict equals to apple and pen, from this word dictionary, we can generate this string apple, then pen, then apple. We can have repetition of word. We see apple repeated twice in this string. So in this case, we have to return true. Now, how we can solve this problem? For sake of understanding, let's assume S equals to LeetCode and word dict equals to Leet and code. First, we're going to construct a hash set, and this is our hash set. This hash set contains two words, Leet and code. Then we're going to construct a dynamic programming table, and this is our dynamic programming table, and the length of this table is the length of the string plus 1. The length of the string LeetCode is 8, so 8 plus 1 is 9. The length of this dynamic programming table is 9. For the first index, we inserted true initially. Why we have inserted true to the first index? We'll talk about that in this video. We have this string LeetCode and we have this set. Now, first we're gonna check this first letter, and this is L. Okay? Does L exist to our set? No. L is not exist. L does not exist in our set. So we'll not change the value at index 1. Then for index 2. For index 2, we're going to get this word, LE. Does LE exist in our set? No, LE doesn't exist. Then we're going to get the letter E. Does E exist in our hash set? No, E does not exist in our hash set. So we'll not change the value at index 2. Then we have index 3. For index 3, we have this word LEE. Okay, LEE doesn't exist. Then EE. EE doesn't exist in our hash set. Then E. E also does not exist. So we'll not change the value for index 3. Then for index 4, we will have this word Leet. Does Leet exist in our set? Yes, it is. Then we're gonna check whatever word we have on the left of the word Leet. We have nothing, right? And we have here true for nothing, because Leet is the word and on the left we have nothing. So this true and it exists in our set. It's also written true. So true and true evaluated true. Then we're gonna change the value here to true. Okay, then we're gonna check EET. We see EET does not exist in our hash set. Then ET. ET does not exist. Then T. T also not exist in our hash set. Then we have index 5. For index 5, we have this word LETTC. We see this is not exist in our hash table. Then EETC. Also EETC is not exist in our hash table. Then ETC. ETC is not exist. Then TC. TC also not exist. Then just C. We see those all word does not exist in the hash set. So we will not change the value at index 5. Then for index 6, we have this word, LETTCO. LETTCO does not exist. EETCO does not exist. ETCO does not exist in our hash set. TCO, CO, and O. All the word does not exist in our hash set. So we will not change the value for index 6. Okay, then for 7, we have this word LETTCOD. And this word does not exist. This word also not exist. This word not exist. This word. This word. Then this word OD. And then the letter, single letter D. All of them does not exist in our hash set. Okay, so we'll not change the value at index 7. Then for index 8, we have this complete word. Okay, we see LeetCode doesn't exist in the hash set. EETCODE does not exist. ETCOD does not exist. TCODE does not exist. CODE does exist, right? COD we have in the hash set. This exists, so it will return true. Then whatever word we have left on the code, we have lit. So let's get the value for T at index 4, right? At index 4, we have true. So true and true is true. So it will be replaced with true. So we will stop here because we don't need to check for the rest when we have found a word that match our condition. And this is how we can solve this problem. I know this solution bit of exaggerated, don't worry. Let me show you how we can solve this problem using the help of pseudocode. First, we're going to declare a function wordbreak that takes a string and a dictionary list. Let's suppose that s equals to LeetCode and wordDict equals to Leet and code. Here wordDict and dictList are the same. Okay? Then we're going to construct a dynamic programming table, the length of the string plus 1. This is our dynamic programming table of length 9. Then we're going to construct a set from the dictionary list. This is our hash set, okay? Then we're going to insert at first position true. Okay, why is that? When you have found a complete word, suppose that we found this word lit. When you found a complete word in the set, then what we will do? We will find the left portion of that word. In this case, on the left portion of this word is nothing, right? For that, we're inserting here true. When we go through the is iterations of our loop, then you will see how it works. Okay, don't worry for now. Now we're gonna run a loop for I from 1 to length of the string minus 1. We're starting from 1 because we already inserted true at the first position. Then we're going to run another loop. This is nested loop for j from 0 to I minus 1. And this will generate word of length from 0 to I minus 1. Then we're gonna check if diffz, and this diffz means if we found the left word, then return true. If we do not found the left word in our set, then return false. Or if we found empty word on the left, then return true. And if the current word is exist in our set, then set true to the current index and then break. At the end, we'll have our answer right here and we'll return that. Okay, dp length s minus 1. Sorry, it should be just dp length of the given string, not minus 1. All right, now let's see how it actually works. For first iteration of this for loop I equals to 1, then we'll have z equals to only 0. So we generated the word of length 1. Okay? And this is L. L does not exist in our hash set. So we'll insert here false. Then for next iteration of this loop, I equals to 2 and j equals to 0. For j equals to 0, we're going to generate a string of length I minus minus z, and that is 2. and that is here LE. LE does not exist in our hash set. Also, E does not exist in our hash set. So let's insert here false. We don't have to insert here false because by default we have the value for all the field false. That's why we're not inserting false here. We can do it by using else statement. We don't need that, right? Then for next iteration, I equals to 3, we have the word LEE. LEE doesn't exist in our hash set. EE doesn't exist. E also doesn't exist. So here we'll have the value false. Then for next iteration, I equals to 4. Then we found a word lit. We see that lit exists in our hash set. Then let's check whatever value we have for the left word. We see the left word is nothing in this case. For that, we're going to return whatever value we have at the index 0. Okay, then we have inserted here true. And we don't need to check for is equals to 1, 2, and 3 because we already found a word that exists in our hash set, and the left word is empty, or we have found in our hash set already. Then for next iteration of this loop, we have I equals to 5. We have generated all possible words. We see no of them exist in our hash set. Then we have I equals to 6. Here also we see no of them exist in our hash set. Then for next iteration of this loop, we have generated all possible words. Here also we see no word exists in our hash set. Then for the last iteration, we see when we have z equals to 4, we found a word code in our hash set. Now let's check the left word if that exists in our hash set. The left word we have for code is lit. And we see that lit exists in our hash set. So it will return true, and we have in our hash set. So this two will return true. At the end, we will insert here true. By default, we have all the value false. This is how we can solve this problem. If you aren't understanding this problem, take a look at for the is iteration. We have break it down the is iteration for the two loops so you can understood easily. You will have an easy time understanding this problem if you take a look at for the all iterations what's going on in the code. We have right here everything. We break it down to make you understand this problem clearly. At the end, this function will return this value true, and this is how we can solve this problem. The solution will take bigger of n squared time complexity, where n is the length of the given string, and it will take bigger of n space complexity to construct our dynamic programming table. Hope you have understood this problem. If you have any question, if you have any suggestion, let us know. Thanks for watching this video. I will see you in the next video.